The poisoned wine bottle puzzle goes like this. Our hero is King Bob, and King Bob is very proud of all the wine that he has in his wine cellar. There are 1,000 bottles which he has been saving for King Bob Day, which is tomorrow. And his joy is dampened by word that one of the wine bottles has been poisoned by not one, but 10 co-conspirators, traitors who want to ruin King Bob Day. Anyone who has even a drop of the poisoned wine will be unaffected for exactly 24 hours, at which time they will die a horrible death. King Bob will not be undone by this treachery, and he tells the 10 traitors that they will have to taste the wine. They themselves do not even know which bottle has the poison. How does he test 1,000 bottles of wine with only 10 subjects? Stop here and think about it. You got it? Okay, here's the solution. King Bob numbers each of the bottles from 1 to 1,000. And then he lines up the 10 traitors from right to left with ascending powers of 2. He then converts the bottle number into binary. Suppose, for example, the poisoned bottle is number 742. Now, the binary code for 742 is 10111 00110. He'll then serve each conspirator a sample of wine depending on where they stand in the line. So in this case, traitors number 2, 6, 7, and 10, they're standing in the zero spot, so they get a taste of bottle number 742. And then in 24 hours, certain traitors will drop dead. Those are the ones in the zero spot. And the ones remaining standing, they are in the one spot of the binary number. Now King Bob just needs to read from left to right the binary number representing by the standing conspirators, convert that into a decimal number, and he will know which bottle is poison. Bob's your uncle, not King Bob, but another Bob. Thank you for watching, and subscribe and stuff, and cheers.